Okay, here's the Ram rebuild kit. You're getting direct from Belsales or from Compulsive Paintball, I believe. You get one replacement ram shaft. There's the old one, there's the new one. You also get a couple of O-rings. The first O-ring is a replacement for this one. The second O-ring, which is in fact a seal, goes down that hole. And getting that seal out is the biggest pain in the arse you are ever going to know. Now, the normal trick to do this would be with a dental pick, but I don't have one, so I'm going to use my very small jeweler's screwdriver. Now, what I'm going to try and do is slide very gently my jeweler's screwdriver down and hook it out. That didn't look like it was going to work. What you can do is, as you slide down very gently, not scratching the edge, you'll hook the seal and you can lift it in and then push it out. Okay, I don't know if you can see that, but I've now successfully disengaged the seal from the hole. What I'm going to do now is push it through. And the easiest way to do that is with an Allen key. Oh, it doesn't want to come out very easily. The thing is, this is a... Ah, there you go. And there is the old one. I'm examining it. See if I can work out why it was leaking. Ah! And there is a little piece of swarf. Anyway, not really important because we are replacing it with a new one. Now, first of all, I'm going to take the O-ring out and I'll put that to one side. So I don't need that yet. I'm going to take this one out. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some grease. There's this stuff, it's called Molly Coat, it's basically Dow 33. What I'm going to do is I'm going to smear a little bit on the outer edge. This is just going to let it seal and keep it keep it from drying out in service. Now the orientation of this seal is very important. The seal itself is not symmetrical. It's a difficult to describe really. It's a bit like a donut, but this side is hollowed out and the hollowed out side has to go inside the ram. So it's basically going to go through a hole that it's much too small for, go down there. The way I normally do it is I squeeze and push and hope for the best. Take my Allen key again. That did not go anywhere near where it should. So what's basically happened is I pushed it past the hole. Push it a little bit back. And it would appear to have fallen in the hole. which is a lot easier than it normally is. Okay, so on with the test. You take the ram shaft, you stick it in. Feels good. The old ram shaft on the old ram was very loose. Now, of course, there's always the chance I've got this the wrong way around. If that's the case, you're going to have to do is remove it and replace it, because it will almost immediately leak when you pressurise it again. Okay, so now what we're going to do is reassemble the ram shaft. Let's hit the new ram shaft. Poke her in. And what we're going to do is we're going to add just a little bit of blue Loctite. Not a lot. It doesn't have to seal, that's what the O-ring's for. Tight by hand. And just because I can, I'm going to give it a little bit of a torque. Not a great deal. And now the ram is completely reassembled. And it's smooth like butter. Okay, next what we're going to do is reassemble this. But before I do that, I'm going to polish some of this discoloration off.